I want to talk about this morning. This morning, today's Friday. Today is leg day for me. Okay, so working out. I'm just going to talk about working out. I've worked out without a trainer for probably almost 4 years, and I work out pretty consistently. I'm not in the best shape in the world, but I'm in pretty darn good shape, but I've done it on my own. Well, I noticed the last 6 months I truly have been slacking. Like, I go to the gym 6 days a week, but am I killing it 6 days a week? Probably not. So I go and I get a trainer named Aaron, and he is relentless, he's ruthless, he's just mean. Now he's the nicest guy in the world, but he's tough. And Friday is leg day, and I got skinny legs and they burn, and I got, my alarm went off at 4:45 this morning to go get beat up by Aaron. And I'm telling you this for a reason, because when the alarm went off, I was thinking of all of these things, like, oh, you know, I've been killing it all week. I deserve to sleep. My body needs to rest. I should stay in. Oh, it's leg day. This sucks. I hate Aaron. Don't really hate him. But I'm thinking of all these things for like 3 minutes, and I didn't move from my bed. And then, like life, like the business you want to start, like the relationship you want to fix, find, or end a really bad one, like the business that you want to scale or start, just like the gym today. If I kept focusing on how bad my legs will hurt, how bad I'm going to sweat, how tired I'm going to be, how fatigued I feel, I wouldn't have went. It's why people don't start businesses, don't fix or end a bad relationship, don't get the company scaling or hire the people you want. Because what happens is we focus on the pain. We focus on what could be wrong. But because this is what I do, after 2 or 3 minutes of that, I got myself out of that and I started focusing on, wow, it is this. I'm gonna be 50 in 2 months. When you're watching this, whether you're watching it live or the replay, November of 18, I'm gonna be 50. I can't believe it. It seems insane. I don't know how it got here so quick. But when I started thinking, no, that's right, I'm gonna be in the best shape of my life in my 50s. I've already decided that. I start thinking about, wow, my kids get to see their dad in great shape, that I can run fast them, I can play with them, and my kids all the time, like, Dad, you look better than my friend's dads that are in their 30s, or run faster, or you don't have a gut. Like, I'm just being honest, and that makes me feel good. I also start thinking about, wow, I want my kids to exercise their whole life. If I don't exercise and I just tell them they should, they're gonna do what I do, not what I say. So they know Dad gets up at 4:45 and goes to the gym every day. When I make them breakfast, I'm sweating. My shirt is soaked. They know Dad went to the gym. It's a part of their life. So I start thinking of after. How am I gonna feel after I do legs? How am I gonna feel when my legs start looking better? How am I gonna feel when I'm in better shape? And all of a sudden I went from, to, no, I'm gonna do this. Because I can't wait for that buzz for when I'm done. So that's not the topic of today, but where in your life are you focusing on the pain of starting the new company, the pain of scaling, the pain of letting go of a job that's killing you so you can go deep into your career? Where are you ignoring and not putting the time, effort, and energy in to fix those bad relationships, whether it's in business or in personal life? What about going to the gym? Don't focus on getting up and going to the gym. Focus on the feeling after. Do that in everything in your life and watch how things change. What do you guys think of that? I'm glad I shared that with you, because that is a huge differentiator.
What's up, what's up? Hey, before you go, you need to watch these next few videos. They're absolute game changers. Hurry up and click right over here and watch them, and I'll see you there.